In his world-famous book Beyond Good and Evil, philosopher Friedrich Nietzsche warned, "And if thou gaze long into an abyss, the abyss will also gaze into thee." Since Nietzsche was not fond of explaining his own aphorisms, many have debated exactly what he meant by this statement, with most taking it to mean that the longer you spend studying an unsettling or evil thing, the more time that thing has to work on you and your perception of the world. This might help explain the PTSD-like symptoms of crime scene investigators hardened against humanity after years of inspecting grisly crime scenes. Whatever Nietzsche meant in his book, just this year, astronomers found that as they themselves stared into the abyss of the cosmos, the abyss began to stare back in a very terrifying way. One night this past October, European astronomers looking through new photos from the Hubble Space Telescope were shocked by the discovery of what's perhaps the most unsettling galaxy yet discovered. The galaxy has been named Arpmedor 2026-424 and has an uncanny resemblance to a human skull. The most prominent and terrifying feature is the two huge eyes, which seem to be staring directly at Earth from millions of light-years away. AM 2026-424, or the Skull Galaxy, is actually two separate galaxies captured by Hubble in the midst of a deadly head-on collision. Galaxies collide all the time, but for two galaxies to run into each other almost perfectly head-on is very rare indeed. In this case, the galactic cores haven't yet smashed into each other, and it makes it look as if the entire formation has two eerie glowing eyes. Below, the eye clumps of stars form what looks like a skeletal nose and mouth, and above the eyes, the stars thrown into a wild elliptical orbit around the new galactic core make the entire formation look like a giant skull. What's even stranger about the Skull Galaxy is the fact that it seems as if two galaxies involved in this deadly head-on collision were about the same size when they ran into each other. That's a very rare event, as typically larger galaxies swallow up smaller galaxies, and equally sized galaxies rarely ever get a chance to collide. The two galaxies that make up this new single galaxy haven't yet finished their merging process, though. And luckily for humanity, it'll probably take another 1 to 2 billion years for the formation to settle into a traditional flattened disk shape. Unluckily for any alien life in those galaxies, things could get very weird over the next 2 billion years. That's because even though the likelihood of actual physical collisions between planets and stars in the two galaxies are extremely unlikely, the effect of gravity could very well become extremely unpredictable. With such a dramatic shift in the galaxy's center of gravity, stars and their accompanying systems could be flung into wild new orbits. Add in the effect of gravity from new stars that make up the other galaxy, and traditional orbits could be thrown into potentially deadly loops. You don't, after all, have to have a head-on collision between star systems to spell doom for life on a planet. The influence of gravity from other stars around yours could be enough to nudge comets and asteroids into new orbits, and they themselves could now be put into an intersecting orbit with your home planet. That's bad news for anyone who doesn't like extinction-level impact events, which is pretty much most life, except crocodiles and sharks, which can apparently survive literally anything except mankind. Star systems could also find themselves completely orphaned from their home galaxy or the newly formed one. That's right, gravitational perturbations of orbits could be so great that a star could very well be flung completely free of the galaxy, doomed to wander the black void between galaxies forever, or at least until it dies. For life on that star system, it might sound like great news. After all, that life would now be basically protected forever from the effect that any neighboring stars could have on them. No more random supernovas to obliterate your planet, or deadly gamma-ray bursts that sanitize the surface of your world of all life. No more orbital disturbances from nearby stars that fling asteroids and comets into new deadly orbits. For intelligent life, though, it might be a very depressing turn of events, because being orphaned from your galaxy also means that you'll never get a chance to explore another star system. No chance of ever discovering alien life that doesn't exist within the realm of your parent star. One day, your species will be guaranteed to die, because you'll be unable to avoid the extinction brought about by the death of your star by simply moving to another star system. Truly a depressing turn of events, yet scientists believe that there's very many of these orphaned star systems, and even within our own galaxy, many orphaned planets as well. Imagine that the Earth got slingshotted straight out of the solar system and forced to wander space between stars with no sun of its own. That's the fate of many so-called rogue planets, or as some call them, dark planets, as they have no light from a sun to shine on them. Skull Galaxy is a terrifying sight to behold, and we can thank our lucky stars, perhaps perhaps literally, that our own galaxy is safe from such chaos. Though our home, the Milky Way, is itself on a deadly collision course with our nearest galactic neighbor, the Andromeda Galaxy, located 2.5 million light-years away. Andromeda is steadily speeding toward us at a rate of about 68.3 miles per second. We aren't quite on a head-on collision course with Andromeda, though that will matter very little in our ultimate fate. The two galaxies are going to fly by each other so close that in relative terms, one could reach out and touch the other. The massive gravity of the two galactic cores will then yank each galaxy back toward the other after initially speeding by, and the two galaxies will begin orbiting around a common center of gravity, gradually but inexorably falling into each other. During the first flyby, entire chunks of galaxy will be ripped out of each participant, with stars flung every which way. The traditional spiral arms of the Milky Way will be bent and deformed, and the extremities will likely be completely amputated. Some of the stars will fall into new orbits within the Milky Way Andromeda system, while others will be flung out into deepest space to die a cold, lonely death in the darkest depths of space. As the galaxies spin nearer and nearer to each other, they'll accelerate, and gravitational perturbations will become even more pronounced. Gas and dust clouds will be sent hurtling into each other, spawning a new age of star formation and creating titanic stellar nurseries. Other stars might be sent directly into each other, obliterating any life in their systems. Yet other stars will suffer as terrifying a death as those orphaned into intergalactic exile. They'll be flung into the newly merged supermassive black hole at the heart of a brand new galaxy. Luckily, all of this is pretty far away though, and given mankind's treatment of its own planets, we're sure to be long extinct before any of this comes to pass. Still, while today we look out into the night sky and are shocked by the skull-like grimace of two galaxies merging into one, perhaps one day, aliens far away will look at our galaxy merging with Andromeda and shudder in fear at the terrifying image such an incredible cosmic event might create. If you like this video, go watch our other video on the most extreme planets in the galaxy right now. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more great videos.